Guys, I know it's been a super long time since I've made a video, and part of what I'll be doing today is letting you guys kind of know what happened. I moved again, but other things too. Anyway, quick rundown on what's going to be going on here. I am just doing a basic whisper video. There will be gaming sounds, like the keyboard and the mouse and such, and it should be super boring, I'm hoping. Skins, because I would like to up my leatherworking, and while I'm doing that, I will just be basically whisper rambling. Now, I do have a new setup because, as I mentioned, I moved, so there's that. Firsthand what it's like to have like severe panic attacks and such, so ASMR definitely has a role in that. Anyway, I'm just flying around if you can't tell. But yeah, anyway, I took that suicide of my friend really hard because I literally the day I had it happen, I had planned on calling him. Well, not calling him, but texting him. Message to, you know, just see how he was doing, because I knew that he was like struggling with loneliness and stuff, and, you know, a lot of times with that stuff it just helps having like somebody give a shit, you know, and just having somebody check up on you can really help sometimes. And in my head I was just like, well, you know, I'm super tired. It's not your fault. You can't blame yourself. And it's like, I know it's not. Decision. Greatest mindset, I suppose. And so every time I would sit down to try to record or make a video, the only thing that would come up in my head was, you know, I need to speak about this suicide thing. Like, I feel like this needs to be talked about. I feel like there needs to be more awareness of this kind of thing, because my friend that killed himself was only 25 or 23. He was even younger. He just, there was some confusion on his age because his Facebook just different than his actual age, apparently. But, it was, you know, it's, he had a, for risk of sounding cliche, but he had a really bright future ahead of him. I mean, he was a good looking guy, he was athletic, you know, he had been in the army, you know, he was funny. But kind of, but like I just cite sources and do research and all this stuff with it and give statistics and, you know, all my sources for where I got the statistics and everything. Because at heart, like, I am an English and linguistics major, so research is kind of my thing. So it has to be done right. And I'm obviously not doing that now. I'm just kind of venting. But yeah, I mean, that's why I'm decided to just go ahead and get on here and talk about it and get it out, because otherwise I feel like I'm just going to sit there and just not make another video, and the next thing you know it's going to be a year later and I won't have made anything because I'm so caught up on not being able to do the one thing I feel like I need to do correctly. And yes, I know this comes from anxiety. It's a tendency for people with anxiety to get hung up on stuff like this, like overthinking and perfectionist tendencies, obsessive compulsive to a certain extent. And yes, I am definitely struggling with that now. And the only way I know to beat it is to suck it up and just do something, even if it's garbage. So this is going somebody something to fall asleep to. So this is me trying to defeat the anxiety and get back to doing things with my channel, because I have a lot of things I want to do. I have like a website and some things I want to start to, but I've just been kind of paralyzed. Like, the anxiety's been literally every day has been kind of like a struggle just to do like the basic things that need to be done, you know, like pay your bills, pay your rent, eat healthy food, take a shower, brush your teeth, make sure you get your exercise done, do your laundry. Like, these things have been an immense struggle for me lately. It just seems so much harder. And I know that comes from anxiety and such too. To fix this, you know, with diet and exercise. I mean, for a bit, I'll be honest, like, I was so overwhelmed for a bit that I was actually using alcohol, which I mean, for those of you that have followed my channel and hear me talk about jiu-jitsu and everything, like, you know, I don't drink, I eat super clean, I do all these things to keep my body extremely healthy. Where it's like, I'll notice myself like wigging out or starting to wig out. I'll get like this real intense like chest pressure, and it'll feel like I can't take a full breath. Like, no matter how deep I try to breathe, it just, it won't happen. It feels like I can't fill my lungs to full capacity. And I recognize that now. I've been to this enough that I recognize that now as a warning sign that I'm probably going to start hyperventilating and lose all sensation in my hands and feet and possibly pass out. So what I have done lately, and this is not like every day, but, you know, maybe once a week or sometimes twice a week, will happen is I'll go get one of those like 22 ounce beers to like just chill it out. And I understand the chemistry behind why it works, you know. It could be that I have like overabundance of glutamate, which is a neurotransmitter that is like it turns your body on, which also explains why I have all these weird like muscle twitches where it's like my muscles won't deactivate. That's also a symptom of that. But alcohol actually blocks the glutamate basically that's what happened, is I just didn't eat for a lot when I was going through the worst of it, and I lost muscle really quickly. It's just a lot when you can't go to like a fast food place, you know, it's difficult to get food. And also I was staying at my dad's, helping him out. He had surgery and whatnot, and he lived way out in the middle of nowhere. It would take like 20 minutes to get fast food. It was just too far away. So a lot of times I just wouldn't eat. Or I'd eat like very little in a day. And then I got to where it's like, okay, I have to eat something. So I'd eat like these little snack packs that weren't necessarily the greatest for you, but at least it was food. Therapist or anything, like, and I don't take medication. I kind of handle everything on my own. I've, you know, up until recently, my coping mechanisms have always been adequate. It was just all that stuff that happened, and then the move and everything, it just kind of, I guess it got to be too much, and there's, you know, there's other things going on too. There's a lot of emotional stuff. When I make something that helps somebody, especially when you guys leave comments and tell me that it really helped, or tell me that, you know, it's helping you sleep or helping you relax or whatever. It's like I said, I struggle firsthand with like anxiety and trying to relax, so I know how important that is. And I apologize if this is not up to par. And I took the apartment that was available. I was kind of in a hurry to get out close to things so I could get back to eating properly and not have to drive 40 minutes to the grocery store I need to get to, or 20 minutes to the closest food source. So I just took a first floor apartment. And I have a Stompy upstairs. That's actually cheaper. That's places where I have carpet. So it kind of absorbs any like echoey sounds, makes it not sound so like what's the word? There's a word for it. See, this is another side effect of like when you're having like anxiety attacks and just anxiety in general or depression, like this is the word I hate the most, like the brain fog. Like I can't think of so maybe it's safe to do this now. I don't know. Let's see which one of these has the least amount of requirements. I guess we're going to try to create as many of these as possible until they go green, which hopefully won't be for a while. Maybe. I hope that didn't pick up my neighbor's opinion.